I'm John Quilter, aka the Food Busker, and I'm back in my beloved black country, the Midlands, Birmingham to be specific.
It's not Wolverhampton, but you can't have everything, can you?
The Midlands is where I grew up. It's where I studied to become a chef at the nationally renowned University College Birmingham. And it's where one of the most important, world-changing condiments was created. That's here, in the Midlands. This is the story of brown sauce. Made here in the Midlands. Brown sauce is one of the most important, groundbreaking, evolutionary changing, most popular condiments in the entire world.
I'm not sure if we can say something now. I'm not sure if it's actually right.
Well, I think it is.
Why do you think it is?
Well, you know, it's like, it's my favourite sauce.
Yeah, but that's just an opinion, isn't it?
And I'm going to be meeting up with one of my old chef buddy mates who's become a lecturer at the university to help me tell this really important story. We're going to meet some of his students and we're going to recreate this condiment. It was created by a local man, an incredible man really, Frederick Gibson Garton, a grocer from Nottingham, the Midlands. And he created the HP brown sauce and invented it here in the Black Country. And it was bottled for many years in Aston, in Birmingham, the Midlands.
But John, I think we're saying the Midlands.
What is your problem? I can't work like this. What is your problem with the Midlands? Like, what is your problem? This is the problem with a lot of people. They've got a problem with the Midlands. Garton, he sold it for a pretty penny. When he sold it to Midlander, Edward Sampson Moore from the Midland Vinegar Company. And he sold it for 150 quid back in the day. That's like £4,000 in today's money.
Yeah, they turned over 440 million last year. Brown sauce.
All right, mate. Okay. Me and Stu Pot studied here at the university over 25 years ago. And now Stu, otherwise known as Stuart Wildsmith to his students, is head of research and development.
Right then, guys, listen up. So today we're going to do brown sauce. It's a perfect brummy condiment. Let's make it good. So guys, let's go.
This king of household sauces starts with the humble onion, peeled, sliced and diced. They are then slowly sauteed on a low heat to ensure no colouring. Then it's a load of Granny Smith apples and a load of tomatoes. These must be skinned by coring and crossing, plunging into hot and then ice cold water, rendering the bitter skins ready for peeling. Then the tomatoes are diced and we're getting ready to start cooking this king of condiments.
But what is it that's so distinctive about brown sauce? Well, do you know?
It's tamarind. Now, our nose, in conjunction with our tongue, is how we as humans can enjoy all the different flavours that come from our food. But the tongue alone can only taste 5 basic flavours: bitter, sweet, salty, umami, and sour. And tamarind is sour. Now, it comes from a leguminous tree bearing edible fruit that is indigenous to tropical Africa. Introduced to Mexico in the 16th century, it is also grown in the USA and the Indian subcontinent. The tamarind tree produces pods containing brown edible pulp, whose key characteristic is a sweet, sour fruitiness. Tamarind paste has many culinary uses, including flavouring drinks, chutneys, curries, and sauces such as Worcestershire sauce and good old brown sauce. It's used as a metal polish. Now, we take the tamarind, some ginger, and grate it. We get a selection of spices, seeds, and herbs to give the aromatics, and then we add them to the pot with the tomatoes, the onions, and the apples. Sweat them for a while, and then it's time to add a whole bunch of water, and we leave it on the stove to cook down for hours. Finally, we add a good glug of vinegar to give it that sharp, distinctive taste, and then it's time to taste. Oh, it's good. Oh, that's so good. That's bob on. All that's left to do now is to pass, blitz, reduce, and then...
Right then, guys, we're going to do a taste test from all these brown sauces today. This one kind of looks ready and done. That's the closest.
I think so. I think that is, it's got all the elements of a brown sauce. It's got that sourness there. It's got the sweetness. It's got the spiciness.
Mm-hmm. I just think that's really good.
I do. Now, brown sauce isn't just a condiment. It can be an ingredient to cook with. And to show that, we're going to cook a beef rendang, which is an Indonesian curry.
And I am going to get the curry paste on.
Oui, chef.
Right, your curry paste, dead easy. Start off with some garlic, ginger and galangal, lemongrass, red onions, oil and chilies. Lid on, flip.
Next up, it's pan on with some oil and you saute off the paste.
Next up is the aromatics. Go for it, John.
Yes, chef. Cinnamon.
Cumin. Lime leaves.
Turmeric and cardamom.
Next up, we are going to add our stewing beef to this. Doesn't it? I mean, look at all that. Look at the colour.
And now it's time to add some coconut milk, which is going to give it its distinctive rich flavour. We let that cook down, add a little drizzle of sweet soy, and then...
So this is the super stuff, isn't it?
This is the original. This is the original...
UCB student.
Forget HP.
Brown sauce.
Yeah, like it.
This is UCB.
I'm going to add a good tablespoon of the student's brown sauce here, and then I'm going to let the whole thing just bubble down and reduce.
Right, so it's been on the stove for about an hour. It's reduced right down. The beef's nice and tender, and the coconut milk is beginning to split, which means that it starts to caramelise. We've got to put the seasoning in. So they are seasoned with fish sauce for the saltiness. We put some palm sugar in there and some desiccated coconut.
The great thing about a rendang is really sweet, but it's also got the sourness, most importantly, from the tamarind, which the brown sauce has definitely given that sort of sour element.
Not bad, bad, John. Nice and coconutty. You're loving it too much, aren't you?
I love it. That's the problem.
It's like a wet, dry curry, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
And it works really, really well. You can really taste the coconut in there. You can really taste all that lovely lemongrass. It's a Boston, that.
Boston.
Aye,
it's Boston.
So basically, people, you've got the Midlands to thank for your brown sauce. You're welcome. And don't you ever forget it. I've really enjoyed coming back to my own. And thanks to everybody at University College Birmingham. Big up the Midland Massive.